Hey Architect Nation, Enoch Sears here. And today I'm gonna give a response to my video that I posted yesterday, the question, can you succeed as an architecture firm owner if you don't have the resources like money, time, and people? So the reason this came up is because a few days ago I posted a video talking about Jeff Bezos and talking about the fact that he was able to put out of business a lot of retail stores because they didn't innovate. And I got a post on a comment on the Business of Architecture blog from an architect named Umberto, and I know Umberto, and Umberto says, you know, what he says probably represents what a lot of people are thinking, what a lot of people are struggling with. So this, here's what Umberto writes. He says, yes, innovation is important, I understand that, but how do you innovate if you don't have the resources to innovate? He says, borrow, right? Question mark. And who can guarantee that borrowing money for an innovation will produce the right ROI, not only to offset the borrowing, but produce more returns so that you can keep innovating without having to keep borrowing? Vicious, vicious circle. In the end, the power always and only will be where the money is, and if there cannot be a guarantee but only risks, only he who has the money can succeed. Very sad story, but true. So yesterday I asked you, the architect nation from around the world, what do you think? Is Umberto's story true? Is it true that only people with money can succeed? Now, there's one of my favorite quotes from Henry Ford. He says, whether you think you can do a thing or not, you're right. So in Umberto's case, I would say, Umberto, you're right. If you believe you can't innovate without money, you are 100% right. However, there's a lot of people in this world who innovate without money, and it's because they have one key that is very, very important to success in business, and this key is the attribute of resourcefulness. Right? It's not about having resources, it's about being resourceful. What is resourceful? Resourceful means being able to come up with the resources, either leveraging partners, being able to partner with other people, being able to, like you said, go out and get a loan, right? Use credit cards to finance something if you need the money. Invest in yourself, right? These are all ways that we can be resourceful. Now, I just want to give you a quick example that my friend Ryan Willard, who's the host of the Business of Architecture podcast over there in the UK, told me. He said that there was this lady who wanted to attend a Landmark Forum seminar. So a Landmark Forum is this forum where you go and you kind of work on personal development and stuff. And she didn't have the money at the time to invest in the forum, but she knew she needed to make some changes in her life. And so what did she do? She had a decision. She could say, nope, I'm not gonna be resourceful. I'm not gonna do what it takes to get myself to the seminar. Or on the other hand, she could say, you know what? I'm gonna find a way to make this happen. You see, it's really about commitment. It's really about how committed are we to actually achieving our goals? What will we actually be willing to do to achieve what we want and bring what we want into our life? And so in this lady, the story goes, is that she went around her neighborhood and she asked people for donations to attend the seminar. She was able to collect enough money to attend, and there she was, able to make start her journey towards transforming her life. Right? Now, this is an example of resourcefulness. Now, I'm sure in your own personal life, you've had experiences where you've been faced with something really big that you thought you couldn't overcome, or you thought you didn't have the resources for it, but you managed to get resourceful. For instance, this house. We recently moved into a new house a little while ago. Well, this was beyond what my wife and I were looking to purchase, right? But when we saw the house, we thought, we gotta have this house. It's exactly what we're looking for. There's not many houses in this area that are exactly like this particular house. It's a beautiful mid-century modern house. It's beautifully landscaped. It has an amazing pool in the backyard. And so you know what? What we did is we said, okay, let's get resourceful. How can we make this happen? Tony Robbins says, the quality of your life is defined by the quality of your questions. Ask better questions, get better answers. So the takeaway from today's video is, and the question I would have you ask yourself is, where in your life do you need to ask a better question? Where in your life is it not about having resources, but about actually being resourceful? Because let's face it, resources come and go. Someone can always take your resources away. There can always be an economic crash. You know, someone could rob you. A disaster could happen. But ultimately, if you're resourceful, no one can ever take that away from you. So let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear your story about a time when you've been resourceful. You can leave that right below in the comments. And as always, carpe diem. Get out there and make stuff happen. This is Enoch, over and out.